In this video, we're going to show you how to properly set up and calibrate the 380 Synergy. What we have on our desk here is a 380 Synergy indicator and a demo scale. This demo scale is going to be set up as a 50-pound scale. Now, there's no weight on the scale at the moment, and our display reads 1,460 pounds. So clearly, this is not properly set up or calibrated. So let's go ahead and do that. What we'll have to do is get into the configuration menu of the indicator in order to perform this. And so to make that happen, we have to begin with the scale powered down. So I'm going to press and hold the power button until the display reads off. Then, during the power up sequence, I have to make sure that I press the zero button while the numbers are counting up. If I don't press the zero button within that time frame, it'll go into regular operating mode and I'll have to start over. So I'm going to press and hold that print button until the scale lights up. During the count up, I'm going to press zero, and now I'm into the setup menu. From here, I'm going to navigate down to config, down to capacity, and down a third time where I see the default value of 10,000. Remember, we wanted to make this a 50-pound scale, so we're going to make the adjustment here for the capacity. My blinking digit starts on the left. I'm going to press the down arrow to change that to a zero. I'll use my up or down keys to change the number as needed. Now I'm going to change which digit is blinking by going left and right. Since I want a 50-pound scale, I'll press my print key until my tens place is blinking, and then I'll use my up arrow to change that to a 5. Now my capacity reads 50.
Yes.
I'll hit tear to accept that, and you notice that the decimal place begins blinking. If I wanted to move the decimal to create a slightly different value, then I could do that at this time. But in the first step, I went ahead and set it exactly as I needed it. So I have no need to change the decimal value at this point. I'm going to go ahead and press the tear button to accept it as it is. Now what I'm going to do is go up to config and go right to format. Here I'm going to come down. I'll see primary, the primary format. And this, these eights with the one on the end, this represents my count by. The default is to count by 1 pound increments. I want my 50 pound scale to count by 0.01 increments, so I'm going to use my left and right arrows to change the decimal location so that it reads 2 decimal places with a 1 on the end. There we go. Now my scale should read as a 50 pound scale counting by 0.01. I'll hit tear to accept this. My primary units by default is going to be pounds, so I won't need to change that. So I'm going to go up until I get back to format. Now I'm going to go right to calibrate, and we'll come down. The first step in this calibration procedure is the W0, so I want to make sure I have nothing on my scale, and that's the case here. So I'll go ahead and press my down arrow button, and we'll execute the zero calibration. We'll wait for the display to read OK, and then we'll hit tear to accept and clear that message. At this point, I have an option of reviewing the zero counts that it just captured. I won't do that now. I'll go to the right, and I see the WVAL. This is where we're going to enter the weight value that will be used for calibration. So we just set this up to be a 50-pound scale. Hambick 44 would recommend that anything under 300 pounds should use full capacity for the calibration. So we're going to go ahead and put 50 pounds on the scale for that calibration. So we'll have to tell the indicator how much we're going to use. So let's come down. We see the default of 10,000 pounds. And just like the capacity, we're going to go ahead and change this to say 50. Here we go. I press tear, decimal begins to blink. I don't need to change that. I'll press tear one more time, and that'll move us to the W span. So the indicator is now looking for 50 pounds to be on the scale when we execute the span. So let's go ahead and put our 50 pound test weight on the scale. Once that's in place and settled, I'm going to go ahead and press my down arrow. Execute that span calibration. Then I'll exit by going back up to setup and pressing that zero key one last time, where it will save and exit. And hopefully we have 50 pounds. There we go. The scale is now set up as a 50 pound scale and properly calibrated.